Hey everyone, and welcome to the Deep Dive. Today we're diving into something that's like the secret sauce behind so many of the apps and systems we use every single day, and that is message queues.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Yeah, so think about this, right? Like, when you order something online,
okay,
you don't have to like sit there and wait for it to ship before you can do anything else on your phone.
Right.
You can just keep browsing or close the app even.
Yeah, exactly.
That's because of something called asynchronous communication. And that's where message queues really come in.
Yeah, they're kind of the heroes in the background making all that happen.
Exactly. So get ready, because in this deep dive, we're going to break down exactly what message queues are, how they work, and why they're so important.
It's going to be fun.
Okay, so first things first, can you give us like a simple definition of a message queue? Like, what is it in a nutshell?
Okay, so imagine you have different parts of a system that need to talk to each other, but they don't need to be online at the exact same time. That's where message queues come in. They're like a temporary holding place for messages. So one part of the system can send a message, and even if the other part is busy or offline, the message will just wait patiently in the queue until it's ready to be picked up.
Oh, okay. So it's like leaving a voicemail.
Yeah, exactly. It allows those different parts of the system to communicate without having to be connected at the same time.
That makes total sense.
Yeah.
So we've got these messages going back and forth, but what are the key players in this whole system?
So there are three main parts to a message queue. The first is the producer.
Okay.
Which is just a fancy name for the thing that creates and sends the message.
Okay, the sender.
Exactly. And then you have the queue itself, which is basically just a storage space.
Gotcha.
Where the messages hang out until they're processed. And then finally you have the consumer, which is the thing that receives and processes the message.
Okay, so producer, queue, consumer.
Yep, that's it.
Okay, this is making more sense now, but can we maybe use an analogy to really drive it home? I'm a big fan of analogies.
Oh, me too. Okay, how about this? Imagine a busy restaurant kitchen.
I like where this is going.
Okay, so the chefs in the kitchen, those are our producers. They're cooking up all the delicious dishes, which are basically our messages.
Okay, I'm following you.
Then you have the counter where the finished dishes are placed. That's our queue. It's holding all the messages until they're ready to be delivered.
Okay. Yeah. And the servers are the consumers, right?
Exactly. They pick up the dishes from the counter and deliver them to the hungry customers.
I love it. So chefs are making the messages. The counter is holding them and the servers are delivering them.
Yep. That's the basic idea.
This is making so much sense. Okay. So we have chefs cooking up messages, a counter holding them, and servers delivering them. But how does this whole process actually work in like a software system? Can you break it down for us?
Sure. So first, a producer creates a message and sends it to the queue, just like a chef preparing a dish and placing it on the counter. Then the queue stores this message safely, ensuring it doesn't get lost. And it keeps track of the order in which messages arrive, so no cutting in line. And finally, a consumer comes along, retrieves a message from the queue, and processes it. This could be anything from sending an email to updating a database.
Right.
It's like the server picking up a dish and delivering it to the customer.
Okay. So it's all super coordinated, even though the producers and consumers are working independently.
Exactly.
But why is this whole message queue system so beneficial? What's the big deal?
Well, for one, it allows for something called decoupling, which basically means different parts of the system can be modified or updated without affecting each other.
Oh, I see.
So going back to our restaurant example, if the menu changes or a new chef joins the team, the kitchen can adapt without disrupting the entire flow of orders. The servers can keep picking up and delivering dishes as long as there's something on the counter, regardless of what's happening behind the scenes.
So it's all about flexibility and not having everything come crashing down if one part changes.
Exactly.
What else? Are there any other advantages?
Oh yeah, for sure. Another big one is scalability. As the system grows and the number of messages increases, message queues can handle the load without breaking a sweat.
So it can handle those busy dinner rushes.
Exactly. It's like having a buffer that absorbs those spikes in activity and keeps everything running smoothly.
Okay, that makes sense. Now, what about reliability? How does using a message queue help ensure that messages don't get lost?
Yeah, reliability is super important. Message queues are designed to be very reliable. They store messages safely until they are successfully processed.
Okay.
So it's like having a guarantee that those dishes in the kitchen won't accidentally disappear or get delivered to the wrong table. Even if a consumer encounters an issue or goes offline temporarily, the message remains safe in the queue, waiting to be processed when everything is back up and running.
Okay, so message queues are all about flexibility, scalability, and reliability. They sound pretty awesome.
They are.
But there's one thing I'm still not totally clear on. What's the deal with asynchronous processing? You mentioned it earlier.
Oh, yeah. So asynchronous processing basically means that tasks can happen in the background without blocking other operations.
Huh?
Think about that online order example again. You don't have to sit there staring at your screen waiting for the order to be processed before you can do anything else.
Right.
That's because the system is using asynchronous processing to handle the order in the background while you're free to continue browsing or do other things.
So it's like multitasking for software.
Exactly. And message queues are often the backbone of this asynchronous magic.
That makes sense. So we've got this whole system of messages flowing smoothly between different parts of an application, thanks to these amazing message queues. But let's get practical for a moment. Where do we actually see message queues in action in the real world?
Oh, there are so many examples. One common use case is in microservices communication.
Okay.
So in a microservices architecture, an application is broken down into smaller independent services that need to talk to each other.
Mm.
Message queues act as the messengers, facilitating seamless and efficient communication between these services. It's like having different teams in the restaurant, the appetizer chefs, the grill masters, the pastry team, all coordinating their efforts to create a delicious meal.
I love how this restaurant analogy keeps coming back. So
yeah.
Message queues are like the coordinators making sure all those different parts of the application are working together in harmony.
Exactly.
Okay, so what are some other scenarios where message queues really shine?
Another great example is task scheduling. Let's say you have a system that needs to perform various background tasks, like sending email notifications or processing large data sets.
Okay.
Message queues can efficiently manage and execute these tasks asynchronously, freeing up resources and ensuring the system remains responsive to user requests. It's like having a dedicated team in the restaurant handling reservations and special requests without slowing down the main kitchen operations.
It's amazing how this analogy just perfectly illustrates the power of message queues. It's like having a behind-the-scenes look at how a well-oiled machine operates. Are there any other common applications where message queues play a key role?
Definitely. Event-driven architectures are another great example. In these systems, actions or events trigger specific responses.
Okay.
Message queues are crucial for routing these events and triggering the appropriate actions. Think of it as a notification system in the restaurant that alerts servers when a table is ready or a dish is prepared.
So message queues are like the silent but efficient coordinators, ensuring everything runs smoothly without any hiccups.
That's a great way to put it.
Okay, so before we move on to part two, I want to do a quick recap of our restaurant kitchen analogy just to solidify everything for our listeners. You game.
Let's do it.
All right, so we have our producers who are like those awesome chefs creating messages, which are like those delicious dishes ready to be served.
Yep.
Then we have the queue, which is like our trusty counter, holding those messages in order until they're ready to be picked up. And then we have our consumers, who are like our super efficient servers, retrieving and processing those messages, making sure every order is fulfilled.
Keeps us.
And this analogy really captures all the magic of message queues, right? The decoupling, the scalability, the reliability, the asynchronous processing.
It really does.
So there you have it, folks. That's the beauty of message queues.
Mm.
But don't go anywhere, because we'll be right back in part two with even more exciting insights about this awesome technology. Stay tuned.
Can't wait. Welcome back. You know, before I move on, I was thinking there's another analogy that might be helpful.
Oh, yeah. I'm all ears.
What about like an airport baggage handling system?
Ooh, okay.
Think of the passengers checking in their bags. They're like the producers.
Okay, yeah.
They're creating the messages, which in this case are the suitcases full of all their stuff.
Gotcha. So the suitcases are the messages.
Exactly. And then the conveyor belts that carry the bags, those are our queue.
Oh, yeah. I see that.
They keep everything organized, moving in a specific order, and make sure no bags get lost.
Right. And the consumers would be the baggage handlers.
Yeah, exactly. They're retrieving the bags from the belts and making sure they get loaded onto the right planes.
That's such a good analogy. It really shows how message queues can keep everything running smoothly, even when things are super busy.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so we've got this great picture of how message queues work. But I'm curious, are there like different types of message queues? Or is it all just one
thing? Oh, yeah. There are definitely different types, just like you wouldn't use a hammer to screw in a light bulb.
Ah, right.
Different types of message queues are better suited for different tasks.
Okay, so what are some of the most common types?
Well, one of the most common is called a FIFO queue, which stands for first in, first out.
Okay.
So in a FIFO queue, the messages are processed in the exact order they arrive. No cutting in line.
Makes sense. What about other types?
Another important type is called a priority queue.
Oh, okay. What's that all about?
In a priority queue, certain messages can be given higher priority based on how important they are. So those messages will jump to the front of the line.
Gotcha. So it's like having a VIP line for messages.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so FIFO queues are all about order, and priority queues are about urgency.
That's a good way to remember it.
So can you give us some examples of where these different types would be used, like in the real world?
Sure. So let's say you're building an e-commerce website.
Okay.
When a customer places an order, you want to make sure the order is processed in the right sequence, right?
Yeah, you don't want to ship the order before the payment goes through.
Exactly. So in that case, you'd want to use a FIFO queue to ensure that each step happens in the right order.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah.
What about priority queues? Where would those be useful?
Let's say you have a system that monitors something critical, like a power grid.
Okay.
If there is an alarm, you want that message to be processed immediately, regardless of anything else in the queue.
Right. That's super important.
So a priority queue would be perfect for that.
Okay. So priority queues are all about handling those urgent situations.
Yep, exactly.
This is making me realize how much thought goes into building these systems. It's not just about the code, but also choosing the right tools for the job.
Yeah, definitely. You have to think about the big picture.
Now, I know we've been talking about all the amazing benefits of message queues.
Yeah.
Are there any downsides? Like, are there any potential issues to watch out for?
Well, message queues are pretty awesome, but they're not a silver bullet for every problem.
Okay.
One thing to keep in mind is that introducing message queues can add complexity to a system.
Right.
You need to manage the queues themselves, handle potential errors, and make sure everything is configured correctly.
So it's a trade-off. You get all these benefits, but you also have to be prepared to handle the added complexity.
Exactly. And another thing to remember is that while message queues promote asynchronous communication, they don't inherently guarantee speed.
Oh, I see.
If a consumer is slow to process messages, it can create bottlenecks and slow down the whole system.
Right. It's like having a traffic jam on a conveyor belt. Okay. So choosing the right message queue system and implementing it correctly is super important.
Yeah, definitely. It can make a big difference in how well the system performs.
Okay. So for all the developers out there who are just starting to explore message queues, what advice would you give them?
That's a good question. I think the first step is to understand the different types of message queues and their characteristics.
Yeah.
Then carefully consider your application's needs and how scalable it needs to be.
Right.
And of course, planning is key. Think about how messages will be routed, how to handle errors, and how to monitor the system.
Those are some great tips. This deep dive has really shown me how important message queues are in building modern software systems.
Yeah, they're pretty essential these days.
Okay, so before we wrap up, I'd love to hear your final thoughts on why message queues are so important in the grand scheme of things.
You know, I think message queues embody a fundamental principle of good software design, which is separation of concerns.
Oh.
By decoupling different parts of a system, they enable greater flexibility, scalability, and resilience. It's like building a house with modular components.
Okay.
You can easily replace or upgrade individual parts without affecting the structural integrity of the whole building.
That's a great analogy. And it really speaks to the elegance and efficiency of message queues.
Exactly. Message queues are essential for building modern applications that can handle the demands of today's digital world. They might be working behind the scenes, but their impact is huge.
Absolutely. Now, for our listeners who want to learn even more and maybe see some visual examples of message queues in action, where should they go?
Oh, definitely check out the Topictrick YouTube channel. They have a ton of great videos and resources that delve deeper into this topic.
Awesome. Now, before we jump into the final part of our deep dive, I want to shift gears a bit and talk about a concept that's closely related to message queues but often gets overlooked. We're going to explore the world of message brokers and how they add another layer of sophistication to this whole system. Stay tuned for part 3, coming up right after this. And we're back for the final part of our deep dive into the world of message queues. We've covered a lot of ground so far, learning about their core concepts and all the amazing things they can do.
From handling those busy dinner rushes to making sure those airport bags get to the right planes, message queues are definitely keeping things moving.
Exactly. But before we wrap up, we need to talk about something you mentioned earlier, which is message brokers. Now, how do those fit into the picture?
Yeah. So think of a message broker as like the ultimate traffic controller for messages.
Okay.
It sits between the producers and the consumers, and it provides advanced routing and management capabilities that really take message queues to the next level.
So if message queues are like the conveyor belts, moving those messages along is a message broker, like the control tower at the airport, making sure everything is running smoothly and directing traffic to the right destinations.
Yeah, that's a great way to think about it. A message broker allows for more sophisticated message routing where messages can be filtered, transformed, and sent to multiple destinations based on specific rules.
So it's like having a super smart system that can figure out where each message needs to go based on its contents or other factors.
Right. Imagine you're building an online marketplace with sellers, buyers, and a delivery system.
Okay.
A message broker could route messages about new product listings to interested buyers, payment confirmations to sellers, and shipping updates to the delivery system all automatically.
That's wild. It's like having an entire team of message handlers working behind the scenes.
Exactly. And message brokers often provide additional features like message persistence, which means messages are stored safely even if the system crashes, and guaranteed delivery, which means messages are delivered at least once even if there are network issues.
Okay, so message brokers sound pretty powerful. What are some real-world examples where they're really essential?
They're widely used in financial systems, where reliable and secure message delivery is super important. Think about stock exchanges, where every millisecond matters, or banking systems, where transaction data needs to be processed accurately and securely.
Right. Those are high-stakes systems.
Yeah, for sure. Message brokers make sure that these systems can handle massive volumes of messages with speed and reliability.
So they're like the unsung heroes keeping those critical systems running smoothly.
Absolutely. And as the amount of data we generate keeps growing, message brokers are going to become even more crucial for building resilient, scalable, and responsive software systems.
This has been such an amazing deep dive. We've gone from the basics of message queues to the power of message brokers. And it's clear that these technologies are playing a huge role in shaping the software that powers our world.
It's been fun exploring all this with you.
Yeah, for sure. Now, for our listeners who want to keep learning and see some cool visuals of message queues and message brokers in action, where should they head?
The Topictrick YouTube channel is a great place to start. They've got tons of videos and resources that can really help you understand these concepts.
That's a great recommendation. And remember, the world of software is always changing, so keep learning and exploring.
Couldn't agree more.
Well, that brings us to the end of our deep dive into message queues and message brokers. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.